Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about normal as an approximation to binomial. Given the probabilities P and Q, where Q is 1 minus P, in sample size N, if NP is greater than 5 and NQ is greater than or equal to 5, then probabilities from a binomial distribution can be approximated by using a normal distribution, where the mean is equal to NP and the standard deviation is equal to the square root of NPQ. So we're going to see examples of that in action, but that's just the rule that I'm talking about. Notation, N is the number of trials, X is the specific number of successes in trials, P is the probability of success in one trial, and Q is the probability of failure in one trial. We get Q by subtracting P from 1. Because we're approximating, we have a continuity correction. A continuity correction factor is used when you have a continuous function to approximate a discrete one. So since the binomial probability is discrete, meaning countable numbers, right? But the normal approximation is continuous, we use the continuity correction for any value of x. So whatever x, which is the specific number of trials that we're talking about, we either subtract 0.5 or add 0.5 to use that value. Okay, so let's look at an example. If n times p is greater than or equal to 5 and n times q is greater than or equal to 5, estimate the probability of more than 14 if your n is 20 and your probability is 0.51. And we're using that normal distribution as an approximation for this. So the first thing you do is check to see if you meet this requirement. So you take your n times p, and n is 20, and p is point six. Let's change that now. So we have 6 and 0.6 and 20. So 20 times 0.6 is 12, which is greater than 5. Q is 1 minus 0.6, which is 0.4. And that's 20 times 0.4, which is 8, and that's greater than 5. So we met the requirement of N, P, and NQ are both greater than or equal to 5. So we're fine. Second step is to find mu in the standard deviation. Remember, mu is going to be N times P, so 20 times 0.6. It's that NP again, which is 12. That's going to be the average, the mean that we're using. And the standard deviation is the square root of NPQ. 20 times 0.6 times 0.4, square root of that is about 2.1909. Okay, so we have our mu, we have our standard deviation, and now we're going to use the continuity correction. Remember, the continuity correction, you take whatever number you're working with, which x successes, we're talking about 14, and it's either corrected to 14 minus 0.5 or 14 plus 0.5, that is 13.5 to 14.5. Since we're looking at fewer than in this problem, we're interested in this higher value, is actually to 14.5. No, we're looking at the lower one. I was right. Sorry. You know, you make mistakes in math. It doesn't mean that you're bad at math. It just means you're capable of making mistakes. So I had a moment there where I was like, wait a second, that should be higher. It should be on the far side of whatever you're looking at. So since we're talking about greater than, we're looking at from the left side, the farthest left from 14 is 13.5 and everything greater than that. If we were looking at fewer than, we would look at 14.5 and down. If you don't know how to use your TI-36X Pro calculator or StatCrunch to do this problem, please take a look at those videos on YouTube. We found out we're going to look at 13.5 and values to the right. This is from StatCrunch. I put in my mean, which was 12, and my standard deviation, which was 2.1909. And I'm looking to everything to the right of 13.5. And that gave me this value right here. Once I have that value, the fifth step is to understand your results. So the probability that they could, by chance, have more than 14, assuming that 60% success was correct, is 0.2468. It's about 25%, which is higher than that 5% cutoff. Since our probability is higher than 5%, we can say that 14 is not a significantly high number because it can happen by chance. It's saying there's a 25% chance that you would get 14 under these conditions just by chance. So that means it's not that unusual, and that means the results do not contradict the researcher's assumption. All right, have a fantastic day. We'll see you next time.